shit right here. The wild honey. This is just, this hits so good. All right. What is going on, you beautiful humans? I'm not like fully zoomed out like I was last time where it was like this. I think this is like, this is the best right here. It's not too close, not too far, but it's a fucking bug. You guys, today is Friday, July 28th. We are officially 12 weeks out as of tomorrow, the 29th, from our very first show. And then 13 and a half weeks out from Olympia Amateur. We hit a new prep low today of 241.6. So almost breaking out of the 240s, you guys, which is good. As long as I, you know, was in the 240s by 10 weeks out, then we were on schedule with everything, dropping about 2 pounds a week. But I'm very, very happy with where we're at, you guys. Little flat this morning, but that's how it be. That's how it be in prep. So I got my first meal of the day right here, you guys. As you can see, we got the cream of rice bowl. 60 grams cream of rice, 100 grams blueberries, 100 grams banana, 16 grams of nut butter from Nuts and More, code Danilo to save. Then we got a good old scoop of the vanilla oatmeal cookie, authentic ISO from Jack Factory. Guys, this shit's bomb. Again, if you guys use my code, please tell me, send me your order on Instagram so I can thank you guys for supporting me and this company. And then we got our 260 grams of egg whites. That's the meal today for meal one. I got a lot of shit to do, you guys. I'm gonna smash this meal, go take my vitamins, go for a walk, get some sun. I got a shit ton of client work to do this morning. So I'll see you guys soon, which will more than likely be before the gym. Oh, I'm gonna give you guys a little physique update. A little seek update. So, legs, definitely really starting to get leaner. We just got body work done. The vacuum's getting nice though. It's getting pretty nice. I should've zoomed down all the way. All right guys, we're gonna go eat right now and then I'll see you guys here in a little bit before we go gym. All right, so no Fritos. Pre-workout, you guys. Look how beautiful this is. We got 80 grams of cream of rice, 2 scoops away, 16 grams of nut butter, and some cinnamon. So, this is our pre-workout meal, you guys. I'm gonna smash this. I gotta finish a little bit more client work, but then I'm gonna show you guys what our little pre-workout stack is, and you guys should order some, because the shit tastes so good, and you support me. And it makes me happy. And it makes me be able to do all this content stuff. I just took check-ins this morning, you guys. You know what? I'll pop my check-ins up on the screen. I'll pop a couple pictures up here just to kind of show you guys how we're looking. It was 241.6, like I said. So, new prep low. Very happy about it. Hopefully, we don't have to make any changes this week since we're dropping. So, overall, guys, we're in a very good spot. I'm gonna eat this, and then I'll see you guys when we have our pre-workout. All right, guys, peep the leg day fit. So we have the shirt on from Jack Factory. Back of it says Jack Factory on it. Got the Iron Rebel tech shorts on. These things are comfy as fuck. We got the white Iron Rebel socks and the new UNC Jordan 1. These dropped, I think these originally dropped like a year ago or a little bit longer. Correct me if I'm wrong. But they just did a re-release on them. My client sell sneakers, and I really wanted to get my hands on these. I've been wanting these ever since like they actually first came out, but guys, they're so fucking clean. Come on now. Come on. We got the black on black, white to match with the white. Come on. They look so good. But you guys, this is my first pair of Jordan 1s. I've been wanting to get my sneaker game up for a while. So I was like, you know what? This is a damn good pair to start with. And I already know I'm gonna have like 60 pairs eventually. But sneakers are something that I like. I like to look good in outfits and stuff. So I'm happy that I got these. It's money well spent. But right now I'm gonna make up pre. I'm gonna show you guys what we're taking today. Cause today we have a posterior focus leg day. Guys, this Rocket Pop pre, I cannot explain it to you guys. It's limited edition still, like I said. Once this shit sells out, they're not bringing it back, unless by popular demand they do. But I'm gonna do a little bit over one scoop of this. Caffeine is only 180 milligrams for one scoop. They have the double scoop technology in it, which I'm gonna show you guys right now. If you wanted to scoop it, but if you guys see, one scoop and then two scoops. So make it a little bit easier on you. But we're gonna scoop of that in the Gila Mix. Code Danilo on Jack Factory and Gila Mix. Save yourself some money. The Gila Mixes are $19.95, free shipping with my code. So get on top of that. The new Slate Blue is one of my top favorite colors that I've dropped. And then you guys, we have 50 grams of IntraCarbs, which I do half Gatorade and I do half of the Carb Surge from Jack Factory, just so it's not all just straight sugar. But you guys, I'm gonna make this up. I gotta dip out and then I'll see you guys at the gym for leggies.
Too late. Oh, baby, I'm crazy.
guys, this is like my fifth time making this clip because I'm trying to get it perfect for you guys. It's literally my fifth time making this. I've almost given up tonight making it, but I'm like, you know what? No, I'm still gonna make it. I've been trying to figure out what's wrong with the audio, with the mic and the camera, but I think this audio is good enough for now. It probably still doesn't sound like 100% crisp how I want it to. I need to look into my mic and see if it's broken, if there's something wrong with it. So I'm sorry if the audio isn't completely up to par, you guys. I will get it figured out. But the main purpose of the video, as you guys can see by the title, saying how I got into bodybuilding. Now, I've touched on this on my Instagram, on my other platforms, but a lot of people don't know that I got into bodybuilding because of my dad's passing back in 2017. Now, this is something only, you know, my close friends know, my family, people on my Instagram that have seen me post about it. But like I said, I feel like, you know, you guys do deserve to know because I have a lot of support from you guys. Like every time I look into the camera, I just like imagine all you guys are just in there in the camera because you guys are watching me. And I have a lot of support from a lot of individuals, and I can't thank you guys enough for supporting me throughout this journey. And like I said, you guys deserve to know. I will probably make a more in-depth video on what happened. If you guys want that in-depth video, let me know in the comments down below. I'm still gonna touch on a little bit in this, but like more in-depth on his death and kind of like the mental aspects of handling it, which like I said, I'll touch on a little bit here. But if you guys want a full video of that, I can totally make one. So 2017, my dad passed away in February. And then my grandpa on my dad's side passed 2 months after that in April. And then 2 months after that in June, my girlfriend and I, almost 3 years, broke up. So needless to say, 2017 was the worst year of my life. But in retrospect, it also molded me into the person I am today. And if it wasn't for those events, I would not be where I'm at right now. I'm a big believer in everything happens for a reason. You know, my dad was needed elsewhere, unfortunately. I know he's by my side every day, though. I have this necklace that my mom got me for my birthday the year after he passed. And it has his name on it. It has his birthday. And it says Volim Te Tata, which means I love you, Dad, in Yugoslavian. Serbian specifically. And this is the best gift that I've ever received, hands down. But like I said, guys, if none of that happened, I wouldn't be in the position I am today. And I know my dad's still by my side. You know, I know he's with me doing everything, every cardio session, every training session. Like, I'm doing this bodybuilding for me, but I'm really doing it for him too. And that's why this prep especially has been a little bit different, because I've been thinking about it a lot, and I've just been thinking about him, you know, being there with me through my cardio sessions, through my weight training, when shit gets really hard and tough. Like, he's in the back of my mind, in the back of my head, like, telling me, like, don't fucking stop. Like, I can just hear his voice being like, don't quit, don't fucking do that, don't quit, like, you can do it, you can push through it. And you know, that's why, like I said, like, I'm doing this shit for him. And that's why this prep is a lot more special than the last couple of ones. So I still did it for him in the past, but again, like I said, this one's just, it's different because I'm thinking about it a lot more. Because I want him to be proud of me and what I'm doing. I want him to see the success that I have in this, even though he's physically not present for it. Like I said, I know he's watching over me every single day. And yeah, it sucks, you guys. It really sucks losing a parent. I can't really explain the feeling of it. I mean, like, the most gut-wrenching thing that you can probably hear is the passing of one of your parents, because, I mean, they were the person that made you, literally. So if you guys have both of your parents, just make sure to call them, tell them you love them. Visit them as frequently as you can. Try not to get mad at them too much or anything, because you only get two of them, and you don't know
when their last day is. You don't know when your last day is. Like, life is very unexpected and short, you guys. So really, like, tell the people close to you that you love them. Hang out with them. Be present. Don't be on social media 24/7 just scrolling. If you're at an event, like a family event, a reunion, a wedding, a birthday, anything like that, put your phone away and be present with people, because those memories are going to live with you forever. This phone, social media, this shit's not going to live forever. Like, when you die, you take none of it with you. Like, all you have are the memories in your head, and I think it's really important to stay present. But kind of circling back to the point of the conversation being how I got into bodybuilding. Like I said, I really started training summertime of 2017. Saw a lot of progress in the first 6 months. I gained like 30 pounds. That's those newbie gains. It happens to almost anybody and everybody if you're training and eating how you should be. People started seeing my progress. They're like, you know, you should compete. Have you thought about competing? Are you going to compete? I was like, no. I was like, I guess I'll like look into it. Looked into it, and I started falling in love with bodybuilding. My cousin's husband, Daryl, he gave me the bodybuilding encyclopedia book, and I read that thing so much. I read that thing through and through, and it inspired me a lot. Arnold, Chris Bumstead, obviously, but even just like other bodybuilders, Urs, Regan Grimes, Derek Lunsford, like all bodybuilders today still inspire me. My friends inspire me, like my people I train with inspire me, like a lot of people do. I look up to a lot of people. I have a lot of good mentors in my life. I have a lot of good people around me. And I think your environment's huge too, you guys, about if you want to get into something, your environment's big. So I'm a big believer about you're a product of your environment. If you don't like your environment, change it. You have the ability to. And yeah, so back again, kind of stepping back here. I did my first show in 2019. I won my teens class. I did my second show 6 months later, won teens again, and then I got seventh out of ninth in men's. Kind of was an eye opener for me. Did my next show at the end of 2020, first in novice, second in my open class, and then I went and did nationals a year later at the end of 2021, and I got 14th out of 40 guys. That show really opened my eyes a lot. I was like, wow, like I really need to grow, take time off, and just do my thing. And taking time off isn't a bad thing, you guys. People are so eager to compete, but if you're not ready, you're not ready. You shouldn't be stepping on stage unless you know you can give up a fight to win. Like, you can go in there and put a damn good fight to win first place, if not overall. And that's kind of where at the point now is, you know, I know I'm going to come in at the top of my weight class, because I'm still 21, 22 pounds above my weight cap. And you know, I know we did everything we needed to do. I know I'm going to do everything I need to do this prep to get to where I need to be. And so it's just a different feeling. It's like, I know I'm checking off the boxes. If you guys aren't checking off your boxes, you shouldn't be competing at all. But like I said, I fell in love with bodybuilding as soon as I got into the gym. It was a really good place of therapy for me to be after my dad's passing. Just because I could go in there, you know, take my mind off things, I didn't have to think about anything, and it just really made me just happy. It made me happy. And I think that's very important for anybody. Whether it's a hobby, a job, anything, you should be doing what makes you happy. You should be doing things that make you unhappy or unfulfilled in life. But yeah, you guys, like I said, I thought you guys deserved to know a little bit more. And like I said, I can touch on this in another video if you guys want, if you guys like these sit-down videos. I don't mind doing these at all. I like to, you know, talk to you guys about mentality and how to keep your mind right, because at the end of the day, if your mind isn't right, nothing is going to work. Your mind needs to be strong. It really does. It needs to be strong. If you want to make it far in life, it really needs to. You need to have a strong mind. As cheesy as it sounds, it's true. So, kind of touching on, you know, the last bit of it, I think things, really traumatic things like that, 100% mold your character, but it can make or break you. you can go down a really good path or a really bad path. And a lot of people, a lot of the time, people tend to go down really bad paths. So don't be that statistic, you guys. If something really traumatic or bad happens to you, turn that situation into something great for yourself. You know, turn into a success for yourself. Don't be a statistic. Don't go down the partying route and like drugs and alcohol and stuff and ruining your life. Make something great of yourself. Turn that situation into something you can look back on and be like, I got myself out of that situation. I pulled myself out of that. Like, I did that myself. But to wrap up the video, guys, I really do appreciate every single one of you. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. Follow me on my other socials as well. Like I said, if you guys like more sit-down videos like this, please comment down below. I'd love to do more of these with you guys. But again, I appreciate every single one of you. If you guys use my code on anything, any of the sponsors that I have, please DM me a screenshot of it, of your order, anything, just so I can personally thank you guys, because you guys do run on my codes. So I really do want to thank you all. But episode 5, that is a wrap. Episode 6 will be coming this week. Again, thank you all so much. From the bottom of my heart, I really do appreciate you guys. We're going to smash this fucking prep. I'm excited to bring you guys along with me and see what we can do. So I'm going to go eat because I'm hungry and then go to bed. But I'll see y'all in episode 6 very soon.